Recipe Challenge. Asking the questions, Jeremy Paxman.
Hello. Modern Cambridge plays ancient Oxford tonight as two colleges established over 700 years apart play for a place in the second round. If the score of the losing team is among the four highest losing scores from these first round matches, they'll get one more chance to qualify. And if they can't manage that, well, at least they can take their nameplates home with them. Merton College, Oxford, was founded in 1264 by Walter de Merton, the Bishop of Rochester, and was the first college in Oxford to receive a charter as a self-governing body. J.R.R. Tolkien was one of its fellows, and alumni include the poet T.S. Eliot, Sir Thomas Bodley, founder of the Bodleian Library, the writer Max Beerbohm, and the American singer and actor Chris Christopherson, who was a Rhodes Scholar there. With an average age of 21, representing around 500 students, let's meet the Merton team.
Hi, I'm Tom. I'm from Rotorua, New Zealand, and I'm reading for DPhil in English.
Hi, I'm Connor. I'm from Cork, and I'm studying philosophy, politics and economics.
This is their captain.
Hi, I'm Pax. I'm from London, and I'm studying English.
Hi, I'm William from London, and I'm studying physics.
Wolfson College, Cambridge, was founded in 1965 as University College, but changed its name in 1973 after a benefaction from the foundation established by the retail magnate Sir Isaac Wolfson. Alumni include the former president of Zambia, Rupia Banda, and the darling of social media and former University Challenge team captain Eric Monkman. Representing around 900 students with an average age of 28, let's meet the team from Wolfson College, Cambridge.
Hi, I'm Rhys Carvosso. I'm from Sydney, Australia, and I'm doing a Master's of Law.
Hi, I'm Alexander Klaus. I'm from Hoyerswerda in Germany, and I'm studying International Relations and Politics for an MPhil.
And this is their captain.
I'm Bonnie G. I'm from Prestwich in Manchester, and I'm studying for a Master's in Environmental Policy.
Hi, I'm Mel Schwing. I'm from NUL, New York, and I'm studying a PhD in Law.
The rules are the usual ones, so fingers on the buzzer. Here's your first starter for 10. What present participle links a painting by Henri Rousseau depicting a moonlit desert and a lion, the infectious disease African trypanosomiasis...
Merton is otter.
Sleeping.
Sleeping is correct. Your bonuses are on books, Merton. In each case, give the words that complete the following titles, all of which begin A History of the World In. First described as a series of little oyster-like essays set in the vast, grey, greasy sea of history. A work by Julian Barnes, A History of the World In...
What do people think?
Sorry?
What do people think?
That's the one with the worms, and that's whatever that means.
Worms.
101 objects, maybe?
Okay, should I try it?
No.
No? Shall I go with
that?
101 objects?
No, it's 10.5 chapters. Mm. Secondly, a 2012 work by Jerry Broughton, Ptolemy al-Adrisi and Vartin Waldseemüller are among those named in chapter headings.
Could it be the British Museum one?
What's that? What's
N people, tide? Possibly.
What people?
I don't know, some number of people, given that people...
100 people.
100 people?
No, it's A History of the World in 12 Maps. And finally, a 2012 work by Neil MacGregor. Its chapter headings include Jade Axe, Ming Banknote and Akan Drum.
That's 101 objects.
It probably is.
It's the British Museum one, which it is.
Okay. 101 objects.
No, it's A History of the World in 100 objects. Bad luck. 10 points for this. As his doctoral dissertation at the University of Jena in 1841, who submitted a Hegelian analysis entitled The Difference Between the Democritean and Epicurean Philosophy of Nature? Arthur University.
Merton Burchard.
Karl Marx.
Karl Marx is correct, yes. Your bonuses this time, Merton, are on economists. In each case, give the surname of the person from the description. All three answers begin with the same three letters. Firstly, the Moravian-born author of the 1954 work, History of Economic Analysis. He popularised the term creative destruction to describe change of the economy from within.
Schumpeter?
Oh, yeah, that's... Yeah.
Schumpeter?
Yeah.
Schumpeter.
Schumpeter is right. Secondly, the US economist, perhaps best known for her collaboration with Milton Friedman on the 1963 work, A Monetary History of the United States, 1867 to 1960.
Schultz?
No, that's Schwartz, Anna J. Schwartz. And finally, born in Bonn in 1911, the author of Small is Beautiful, A Study of Economics as If People Mattered.
I don't know. Pass, sorry.
That's E.F. Schumacher, the former coal board economist. 10 points for this. Which chemical element is found in all three of these substances? Saltpeter, laughing gas and ammonia.
Merton is otter.
Nitrogen.
Nitrogen is correct. These bonuses are linked by a word. In which of Shakespeare's histories does the title figure exclaim, "The game's afoot, follow your spirit," urging his troops to shout his name in a charge against the enemy?
Henry V.
Correct. Trouble was already afoot in Switzerland, in the Republic of Krakow and in Sicily. These words of the historian Norman Davis refer to which revolutionary decade of the 19th century?
1840s.
Come on.
1840s.
The 1840s is correct. The game is afoot, not a word. Into your clothes and come. Who rouses his companion with those words in a short story which first appeared in the early 20th century?
Sherlock Holmes.
Correct. We're going to take a picture round now. For your picture starter, you'll see the titles of four major non-fiction works. The same word has been removed from each title. 10 points if you can give me the missing word.
Merton O'Shearhorn.
Philosophy.
Philosophy is correct. Your picture bonuses are three more sets of philosophical works with a common word removed from their titles. I want the missing word in each case. Firstly...
Logic.
Correct. Secondly...
Knowledge.
Knowledge is correct. And finally...
Ethics.
Ethics is correct. 10 points for this. Which South American city is the setting of paintings such as The Bridge at Boca by Benito Martin and The Reconquest by Charles Fourcade? The latter depicts the surrender of a British force attempting to gain control of the River Plate in 1806.
Wilson Close.
Montevideo.
No, anyone like to buzz from Merton? You may not confer. One of you may buzz.
Merton O'Shearhorn.
Buenos Aires.
It is Buenos Aires, yes. Your bonuses this time are on mathematics. Born in County Sligo in 1819, which mathematician gives his name to a basic theorem in vector analysis, sometimes known as the curl theorem?
Stokes.
Stokes is correct. Born in Nottingham in 1793 and working for much of his life as a miller, which self-taught mathematician gives his name to the two-dimensional equivalent of Stokes's theorem?
Is that green?
Possibly, go for it.
Green?
It is green, yes. The divergence theorem in vector calculus is often known by the name of which mathematician, born in Brunswick in 1777?
Where's Brunswick?
Brunswick is German, right?
That's too late for Gauss.
No, it's Gauss.
Gauss.
Gauss is correct. 10 points for this. Referring to the object's likely origin, for what does the capital letter I for India stand in the alphanumeric designation of the object otherwise named as Oumuamua, an asteroid observed in 2017 on a hyperbolic orbit?
Merton is otter.
Interstellar.
Interstellar is correct, yes. Your bonuses are on Winston Churchill. Firstly, for 5 points, as an example of anaphora, or repetition for emphasis, what word did Churchill use in a speech in May 1940 alongside the qualifiers at all cost, in spite of all terror, and however long and hard the road may be?
Sound like we will never, never surrender.
We will fight.
No, it's victory. In his History of the Second World War, Churchill wrote in War Resolution, in Defeat Defiance, and in Peace Goodwill. What quality did he pair with victory?
Magnanimity.
Magnanimity is correct, yes. Of which military figure did Churchill say, in defeat unbeatable, in victory unbearable?
Yeah, that must be Stalin.
This might be one of the Russian ones.
Yeah, I think it might be Stalin.
That sounds like Stalin.
No, I think it's logical.
Montgomery?
No, I think it might be the main Russian general's name.
Oh, Zhukov.
Zhukov, yeah. I think it might be Zhukov.
Maybe? Okay.
If you're sure.
I'm not sure, but I'm guessing.
We'll go for it.
Go for it.
Zhukov?
No, it wasn't. It was Montgomery. Bad luck. 10 points for this. In anatomy, what five-letter adjective indicates the location of all of the following? The epicanthic fold, the atria of the heart, and the biceps muscles.
Martin O'Shehan.
Upper.
Upper is correct, yes. You get 3 questions on the flags of British Overseas Territories. Firstly, the flag of which territory features a pineapple partly concealed behind a turtle, representing the island's original Spanish name of Las Tortugas?
That'll be one of the Caribbean ones.
Jamaica, maybe?
Jamaica's not a British territory.
No, it's not a British territory.
And what's Antigua and Barbuda?
Are they Virgin Islands?
Yeah, sure.
I was guessing.
The Virgin Islands?
No, it's the Cayman Islands. The flag of the British Virgin Islands depicts 11 oil lamps surrounding which saint who holds a 12th lamp? A legendary figure of the 4th century, she and her followers are traditionally believed to have been martyred in Cologne.
It's 10,000 virgins, isn't it? It's Ursula, I think.
Ursula. Yeah.
Or possibly Catherine.
Which one?
Ursula.
St. Ursula?
St. Ursula is right. The image of a ram on a grass tussock appears on the flag of which British Overseas Territory about 500 kilometres east of the Strait of Magellan?
Falklands, right.
The Falkland Islands?
That's correct. 10 points for this. In March 2019, China's launch of a communications satellite was the 300th by a family of carrier rockets bearing what two-word name? That of a nation-building event that began in autumn 1934.
Merton is Otter.
The Long March.
Long March is correct, yes. You get 3 questions on contemporary choreographers, Merton. Rework for 2020, Enter Achilles, is a work first created in 1995 in association with the performers by which Australian-born choreographer, a founder in 1986 of DV8 Physical Theatre?
Smith.
Really?
I don't know. What do you have?
Smith.
That's Lloyd Newson. Secondly, which Edith Wharton novella inspired Cathy Marston's 2018 ballet Snowblind? It concerns the relationships between a struggling farmer, his wife, and their hired girl.
Is it something like The House of Mirth?
I think it's not The House of Mirth.
Okay.
That's not the plot of The House of Mirth, but I don't know any
others. Yeah,
Portrait of a Lady, is that one, or is that by someone else?
Give it a go.
I don't know anything like Wings of the Dove.
Come on.
Wings of the Dove?
No, it's Ethan Frome. Consisting solely of works by female choreographers, the 2019 show She Persisted took its name from a controversial remark directed against which US politician?
That's Elizabeth Warren.
Elizabeth Warren.
Correct. Right, we're about halfway through. We're going to take the music round now. For your music starter, you'll hear the overture to an opera. For 10 points, please name its composer.
Waltz and Close.
Haydn.
No. You can hear a little more, Merton, if you like.
Martin O'Shehan.
Is that Bizet?
No, it's Rossini. It's the overture to the Thieving Magpies. So, music bonuses in a moment or two. 10 points at stake for this starter question. Coined by the Scottish physicist James Alfred Ewing and derived from the Greek meaning to be behind, what concept in economics, often applied to unemployment and trade, refers to a situation in which the consequences of an event are...
Martin is Otter.
Hysteresis.
Hysteresis is correct, yes. You'll recall a moment ago you heard part of Rossini's overture to the Thieving Magpie, which gives its name to the first part of the Wind-Up Bird chronicled by Haruki Murakami. Your music bonuses are three more classical works that have particular significance in Murakami's novels. Name the composer of each. First, this piece, which is a portrayal of a traveller's homesickness. That's Liszt. That's from Years of Pilgrimage, which plays a large part in Murakami's colourless Tsukukuru Sasaki and His Years of Pilgrimage. Secondly, this symphonic work, please. Now that's Janáček's Sinfonietta, which is frequently referenced in IQ 84. And finally, this piano trio. I'm afraid you think wrong. It's the Archduke, it's Beethoven, which is a recurring theme in Kafka on the Shore. So, Wolfson, still plenty of time to get going. 10 points for this. The Anglo-Saxon poem Beowulf contains over 1,000 examples of what literary device that uses compound words or figurative play?
Merton Butchart.
Kenning.
Kenning is correct, yes. Your bonuses are on butterflies this time. In 2019, the UK saw the greatest influx in a decade of what species of migratory butterfly? Its upper wings are a pale orange with black tips and white spots.
No idea. Anyone know any species of butterfly? Monarchs are purple.
Okay, so it's not
them. Any others? If not, go for monarch.
Yeah, why not?
Well, you can't be monarch if you know it's purple.
I don't. I'm not sure.
Okay. Monarch.
No, it's a painted lady. In the same genus as the painted lady, what is the common name of Vanessa Atalanta, a widespread butterfly with dark wings and a band of orange or red?
Anyone know any species of butterfly?
There's something that's called something like orange tip or something like that. But I don't know if it's
not tip, though. Is that it's black tip?
Yeah, I don't
Just one of them will probably be monarch. We could just go for that.
Every time. Monarch.
No, that's the Red Admiral. And lastly, found mainly in East Anglia, what is the largest species of butterfly native to Britain? It takes its name from the tail-like extensions of its hind wings.
So it's not going
to be...
Something
about
long tail?
Wing tail, I don't know.
No, something. Could be monarch if it's red.
Long tail?
No, it's a swallow tail. 10 points for this. Quote, my music is best understood by children and animals. Who said that in 1961, 10 years before his death, and more than 30 years after the appearance of works such as Pulcinella, Oedipus Rex, and the Firebird?
Martin O'Shehan.
Stravinsky.
Stravinsky is correct, yes. You get three questions on science fiction and religion for your bonuses. Which novel of 1968... by Philip K. Dick, features the fictional religion of mercerism, whose followers commune using empathy boxes.
Is that, Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep? That's by him, anyway.
He wrote a lot, though.
Blade
Runner, isn't it? You think mercerism
Well, I don't know any other. Do you know?
I know Man in the High Castle, but it's not that, so go for that.
Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep?
That's correct. Which US novelist wrote Parable of the Sower and Parable of the Talents? They explore the development of a new belief system called Earthseed in the aftermath of major climate change.
Earthseed's the Gwyn, but that's something different.
You think Ursula Le Guin?
I mean, who else is it?
Yeah, well, if there's an Earthseed link with her, maybe.
Come on, let's have it,
please. Ursula Le Guin?
No, it's Octavia E. Butler. And finally, in Margaret Atwood's The Handmaid's Tale, what biblical name is given to the theocratic state that's replaced the USA?
Sons of Jacob?
No, it's Gilead.
No, it's the Republic of Gilead. 10 points for this. In which Canadian province or territory is the delta of the Mackenzie River? This river rises in the Great Slave Lake and flows more than 1,500 kilometres into the Beaufort Sea.
Wolves and Clothes.
Quebec.
Anyone like a buzz from that?
None of us.
No, it's the Northwest Territories. Another starter question, 10 points for this. Name either of the sports represented by initial letters in the abbreviation IBSF, this being an international governing body for two winter sports.
Wolves and Schwing.
Bobsled.
Bobsled is correct. The other one is the skeleton. Well done. That's got you off the mark. Here are your bonuses. They're on physics. In physics, the sentence, sober physicists don't flirt, is a mnemonic to help remember the identification of what?
DF.
Are they quarks? Maybe. So SPDF. Oh, no. SPDF is the groups in the periodic table.
No, it's not. So, it's atomic or molecular orbitals. Oh. In the SPDF notation scheme, for what does the letter S stand?
Sigma.
That'd be sigma.
Sigma.
No, it's sharp. And for what does the letter D stand?
Well, it's not going to be delta, is it?
I mean, do we have anything else?
Just no, delta.
It's diffuse. We're going to take another picture round now. For your picture starter, you'll see a still from a film. 10 points if you can give me the film's title.
Waltz and Swing.
12 Monkeys.
12 Monkeys is correct. By Terry Gilliam. It was inspired by Chris Marker's 1962 short film, La Jetée. Your picture bonuses are three more feature films developed from shorts, this time by their own directors. 5 points for each film you can name. Firstly?
District 9.
District 9 is correct. Secondly?
She'll give you a Coleman, right? Where's she in?
It's something Alice.
Alice.
It's not still Alice.
Do you have anything else?
No. I mean, go for Alice.
Okay, I'll let you say it.
Still Alice?
No, it's Tyrannosaur. And finally.
Oh, this is the horn.
This is the Babadook. The Babadook. Looks like it. Yeah,
go for the Babadook. I'll let you say it.
The Babadook?
It is the Babadook, yes. 10 points for this. Auricula, candelabra and polyanthus are all classifications of which genus of flowers with species including the cowslip and the oxlip?
Wolfson G.
Orchids.
No, anyone want to buzz from Mercy?
Merton O'Shehan.
Tulips.
No, they're primroses or primulas. 10 points for this. In physics, what adjective is applied to the minimum mass of a fissile material required to sustain a chain reaction?
Merton is Otter.
Critical.
Critical is correct. Your bonuses are on China, Merton. Yunnan province shares borders with three countries. Name two of them.
Vietnam and what's going to be
Cambodia?
Maybe, yeah. Could be Laos.
I don't think Laos borders China.
Okay, fine, go for Cambodia. Vietnam,
Vietnam and Cambodia, then.
Come on, let's have a...
Vietnam and Cambodia?
No, it's Vietnam, Laos and Myanmar, so we can't accept that. Right, 5 points for this. Name either of the Chinese provinces that borders North Korea.
No idea.
Is that one Manchuria?
No, I don't think it's called that anymore.
Sure. I'll go for
anything else. Manchuria. I don't think it is that.
Manchuria.
That's Jilin and Liaoning. And finally, which autonomous region of China borders Kyrgyzstan?
Xinjiang. Isn't Tibet autonomous?
Xinjiang.
Nominate O'Shehan.
Xinjiang.
Xinjiang is correct, yes. 10 points for this. Of the six wives of Henry VIII, name the two who appear as characters in the play usually attributed to both Shakespeare and John Fletcher.
Merton Burchard.
Anne Boleyn and Catherine of Aragon?
Correct. You get three bonuses on the Mall in London. Which architect oversaw the broadening of the Mall and the renovation of the frontage of Buckingham Palace in the early 20th century? He also designed the Royal Naval College in Dartmouth.
Any ideas?
I have the name Cowper in my head, but he's much earlier, isn't he?
Yeah, I think so.
No idea.
Pass.
It's Sir Aston Webb. The sculptor Sir Thomas Brock designed what edifice, part of Webb's programme of modifications to the Mall? It was not completed until 1924.
No. Anything? Pass, sorry.
That's the Victoria Monument. And finally, designed by Webb during the same period, what building separates the Mall from Trafalgar Square?
You two live in London.
I know, but I don't go there.
So you've got the National Gallery, you've got Canada House.
Yep.
Have you got on the other side?
Postcard Hill.
I don't
know. Nothing.
Come on.
Pass, sorry.
It's Admiralty Arch. 10 points for this. Filiform and fungiform papillae are small, bumpy projections found on...
Orson Carvoso!
The tongue?
The tongue is correct. These bonuses are on rodents, Wolfson. What alternative common name is given to the nutria, a large amphibious rodent native to South America?
It could be an otter, it could be... No, I think that sounds good.
Bison red?
No, it's the koipu. Oh. Secondly, what six-letter name is given to several species of the rodent family Dipodidae? They generally live in desert habitats and have elongated back legs adapted for jumping.
It's like the kangaroo, but it's going to be six words.
Six letters.
It's a rodent. It's like a...
No? Pass.
That's the jaboa. And finally, reflecting the family to which they belong, the guinea pig has what short alternative name? Come on.
Gerbil.
No, it's the cavie. At the gong, Wolfson have 40, but Merton College, Oxford have 210. Well, you never really got going at all, did you, Wolfson? Bad luck. If you'd had one lucky question at the start, it might have turned out slightly differently. But congratulations to you, Merton. That's a terrific score, and we shall look forward to seeing you in the next round. I hope you can join us next time for another first-round match. But until then, it's goodbye from Wolfson College, Cambridge.
Bye.
And it's goodbye from Merton College, Oxford.
Goodbye.
And it's goodbye from me. Goodbye.